Two bands we love on Soccer M are the Libertines and the Cooper Temple Claws. So when we heard Carl from Libertines and Ditch from Cooper had formed a band, we knew it was going to be great. Ladies and gentlemen, it is Carl and Ditch from Dirty Pretty Things. Coming.
Hi, how are you? You alright?
Alright. While you're while you're settling down, let's have a look at you in action. You were at a gig last night in Wolverhampton,
Yeah, had a good time.
You been to bed yet?
Yeah.
This is going to be interesting. Okay.
Isn't it?
That is your single.
Seriously?
Yeah. And your album out on Monday. Number 3 in the midweek. You happy with that?
Yeah.
All right.
Helen?
How were the good people of Wolverhampton last night? Were they nice? Good gig?
I think they were a little bit troublesome last night.
Were they?
Yeah. At the end of it all, I think they were happy with it.
All right. And sadly, milk as well.
What do you mean just milk as well?
That was smell.
Milk as well as what?
Oh, come on.
And sadly, you have to leave us early today, don't you? Because you're going up to Dundee.
Yes,
it's
not already.
It's the Radio 1's big weekend, isn't it?
Yeah.
I think you've already had quite a big weekend, haven't you? Thank you very much. They asked me for Stan Hibbert's beer earlier.
Is it out the back there?
I saw it.
You never came back to us for that, did you?
No, I didn't, because I don't know where it is. Come on, tell us about your new band then.
Well, working very hard.
Good.
Your milk spitting fool.
Yeah. Got this thing with milk. It's not to do with the band. It's just always happened.
I'll take over from there.
Yeah, sure.
So, we've been received particularly well. We're pretty happy about it so far. So good. We're still fighting a good fight, so to speak. And let's put some milk.
No,
I'll tell you what we're going to do. We're going to have a look at where you're playing. Here we go. This is where you're playing if you want to go and see Dirty Pretty Things. I've heard the album and I think it's really good, guys. So it is top notch.
Would that be on the telly?
Would that be on the telly? Yeah, it's kind of live. Anyway,
it hasn't got any tracks on it.
No, it hasn't yet. But yours makes it on there. So
well, it hasn't got any tracks on it.
Yes, but it does make it on there. We'll leave it there because you're a little confused.
I don't understand.
If it's live, it's gone.
Well, it makes no sense.
Carl and Dids from Dirty Pretty Things. I imagine Wolverhampton's a good night out.
Coming up after the break, Richard E. Grant is on the stage for our FA Cup final special. We're here with Paul Robbins. England's number one. Noel Gallagher. Carl and Dids from Accrington fans.
Plenty still to come, including Richard E. Grant, Liverpool's teammates, and a final question of the season from Tubes. But first, we've got another one of our favourite Paul Robinson clips. Here's you taking out a mascot.
Hi. I hope he's a friend of yours.
No, he's all right, actually. But I think they've refused to buy a new chirpy costume next year because players keep defacing it.
Denting it, punching it in. Come on, Michael Owen. Come on, the World Cup. And talking of strikers, as the last ball was kicked in league competition last week, it means we now know the winner of the Soccer AM Golden Shoe. And its European counterpart, the Golden Espadrille. Oh, which you won't see there. The rules are you have to have played in over half of your league games, and it's worked out on a goals per game ratio. So here's who's won the domestic version, the Golden Shoe. It's Thierry Henry. Yeah. For the third season in a row, it's Thierry Henry.
And here's who,
table.
Here's who triumphed in the European version of the Golden Espadrille, which is for players in Europe's top three leagues. And Thierry Henry's done it again. Oh. He's top of that. A goal scoring machine.
So Thierry has won both awards three times in a row then. That's a treble double. And as per the last two seasons, earlier this week I made my annual pilgrimage to Arsenal's training ground to present the slip-on and the flip-flop to Mr. Henry.
Such a tough bloke, isn't he?
He is really, yeah.
I can't believe he keeps them.
He said that he was going to bring them in. He told a member of Arsenal staff, he said, I'm going to show Soccer AM that I keep those shoes, I'm going to bring them in. And he forgot, and he sent a car back to his house for them because he so badly wanted to show us that he does keep his golden shoes and espadrilles.
I wonder where, though.
Oh, he said in his office, but his office is probably as big as this studio, so probably. I suspect he's got room.
Yeah. All right, Noel Carr, Enemy this week, did a survey to find out the 50 greatest rock and roll heroes ever. You're both in it. Noel, you're number 7. Carl, you're number 5. Let's have a look at the list. What do you make to that?
I'm kind of happy with that, because I'm getting on a bit.
I did have a look at it, and Noel is getting there. He's not.
No. 10 years ago, I'd been out of it.
To be honest, I remember, like, years ago, listening, it was, the first single I heard was,
this could be a long story.
but it's a good one. the Garden Grove. Anyway, that song was the first band I heard who had melody and passion and intent. So that inspired me greatly. And after thanking you,
did you hear that? That's a pleasure.
and those three things inspired me. So, I mean, you have lists every week on the telly and every kind of bollocks program.
Apologise for swearing.
Every kind of silly program, you have these lists. Yeah. So,
you enjoy this,
but just to be associated with these boys is. For me, an accolade and something I'm proud of.
It's not too dissimilar to being with Liam, apart from the violence. Liam's kind of like that, but he's immensely mean and menacing.
Liam's number 4.
He's mean.
He's slipping it. He's slipping, isn't he?
Don't you think? Well, we should. Terry Hall doesn't even make it in there. 50. Terry Hall doesn't make it in there. Rubbish.
Well, what can you say?
Where are you in the damn list, Lovejoy?
It's a very good point. Rock and roll heroes. Right, thanks guys.
TV heroes, Johnny Ross.
Right. He's alright. Because it's a special day, we've gone for a special taxi. It's a recent one, but it's our favourite of the season. It's time to take a little trip to Darlington.
Oh yes, you know it. Taxi for Bra.